Class started at 9. In the summer, we're full. We would line up outside, put up the flag. In the wintertime, we'd say allegiance to the flag inside. Our first 10 minutes was music. You had like 50 minutes of music and 50 minutes of this and for each, you know, so we got the music in every morning. I would have the phonograph and play music on the phonograph, and oftentimes we'd sing songs or the kids would suggest a song or something. So that was our opening of the day, was music, and then we would just go into the studies. We'd have reading classes first, I think. We alternated. We had like reading 3 times a week, arithmetic 3 times a week, then maybe spelling just twice a week. So we'd alternate that way to get the classes in.
I always remember the inside toilets because I was scared of it. I didn't want to use them. And they smelt between the hallway and behind our desk. The girls were one side, the boys were the other side. Yeah. We came into a school to a room where we hung our clothes and put our boots. And then we opened the door and then we were in the school. We had the chalkboard in front of the school. It was behind the teacher's desk. It was a fairly large chalkboard. I sometimes stay after school and erase the chalk off of the board. Now and then, I had other things in my mind I wanted to do. Play baseball. I think it was $100 a month. And I thought, oh, $100 a month. Beautiful. But I think that's about what it was. That was big money, $100 a month. That was when my brothers would be helping the neighbors maybe or somebody for $1 an hour.
We had rang that bell every morning, And also at lunchtime when we got through playing softball, why, I'd have a kid run up and ring the bell, and that was a sign to gather. I loved that bell. That was also protection for us because there was no telephone. I don't remember a fire extinguisher, nothing. But my neighbor, Walter Blunk, told me, Marilyn, if you have an emergency, you ring that bell and you ring that bell and people will come all from all over to help you. So I always felt that that was a safety thing, even if somebody would come that I would be frightened of or whatever, you know. And so I always thought well of that bell. I loved it.
We had a lot of swings and we had the giant strides. We had the monkey bars and I liked the giant strides. If we could get a big boy to run with the giant boy, would whirl us way up in the air. Sometimes I would get scared. I'd go up because I was young and skinny and I would really fly, but oh, I loved it.
In 1953, this letter came from me, from John McBride. What in the world is John sending me something? And so here, sent me this note with his picture. And he's thanking me for being one of his teachers. And it was his graduation from high school. And so that's the picture, and this was the note that he sent me. I always thought that was wonderful. I've kept it all these years. That's how wonderful I thought it was.
I loved Forest Grove School. My friends and playing baseball. And it was just a good school. Nobody fought with nobody or nothing, you know. I can't remember anybody being dissatisfied with anything.
And this makes me sad when I go down home. That school there was sold for someone to add a room to their home. No, I think this is very, very important. As time goes on, people are going to realize how important that is out there, that it was something that was stationary and it's something that's not going to go away. I'd do anything I could to help them. Well, it was home. 5 days a week, and I loved every bit of it. And it was my home.
all the classes are in one room. I know people say, well, what class did you teach? All of them. How do you do that? You know, question then. It was my first school where I taught. It'll always be special to me. And where I lived in Sioux City, they have one restored that they moved into town near a school. And every year it was utilized as the way school days used to be. And the teacher and the students are encouraged to maybe dress. But yes, I think it's very wonderful that it's going to be restored. Yep, it should be. That is an important part of our nation's education, is the country school.